Next is paragraph type question. It says that fx is equal to ln x whole square plus 2 ln x for x greater than 0. And a and b are given to us, where a is less than b. These are the points of tangency of two tangents drawn from origin to the given curve. So we have to find the value of ab. See, we are given fx, so we can find dy by dx. Let us say fx is equal to y. So dy by dx is equal to 2 into ln x divided by x plus 2 by x, right? This is dy by dx. So at x equal to a, dy by dx at x equal to a is equal to 2 ln a divided by a plus 2 by a. Also, we can find the slope because it is tangent from origin. So also we can say dy by dx at x equal to a is also equal to f of a minus 0 upon a minus 0, right? So we have f of a upon a equal to 2 ln a upon a plus 2 by a. Both of them are equal. Now f of a is ln a whole square plus 2 ln a divided by a. So this is equal to 2 ln a by a plus 2 by a. So here we see these two will get cancelled. So we have ln a whole square equal to 2. That is ln a equal to plus minus root 2. That is a is either equal to e raised to the power 2 or e raised to the power minus root 2. As we have a less than b, so we have a equal to e raised to the power minus root 2 and b is equal to e raised to the power root 2. So ab is equal to 1. So option number d is correct. Next is question number 52, which says number of values of x satisfying the equation 5x into f dash x minus x ln 10 minus 10 equal to 0. So we have 5x into f dash x, that is 2 into ln x upon x plus 2 by x minus x ln 10 minus 10 equal to 0. So we have 10 ln x plus 10 minus 10 is cancelled, minus x ln 10 equal to 0. That is 10 ln x equal to x into ln 10. That is ln x by x is equal to ln 10 by 10. So we have to basically find the solution of this equation. Now to solve this, let us take hx equal to ln x by x. So here if we find h dash x, it is 1 minus ln x. So this is equal to 0 at x equal to e. And at x equal to e, value of h is, this is equal to ln e by e, that is 1 by e. So let's draw the graph of hx. As it will have maxima at x equal to e, right? So the graph will be like this. We have to find its solution with ln 10 by 10. Its value is approximately 0.23. So the line will go like this. So we have two solutions, which means that option number C is the correct answer. Next is question number 53, which says which of the following is or are true about fx. We have to talk about the critical points and stationary points of fx. So for that we find f dash x, that is 2 into ln x upon x plus 2 by x should be equal to 0, that is ln x plus 1 divided by x is equal to 0. As x is always greater than 0, so it means ln x equal to minus 1, that is x equal to 1 by e. So at x equal to 1 by e, we have critical point. So before attempting it, we should know what is critical point. Critical point is those points where f dash x are not defined or f dash x is equal to 0. And stationary points are those where f dash x is equal to 0. We can see here that fx and f dash x are defined everywhere for x greater than 0. And f dash x is equal to 0 at one point, that is x equal to 1 by e. So we have one critical point and one stationary point. So answer is A and B. Now next is paragraph for question 54 and 55. Let y1 and y2 be two solutions of the differential equation dy by dx plus px into y equal to qx. So we have to find the general solution of this one. Right. So we are given dy by dx plus px into y is equal to qx. As y1 and y2 are its solutions, so it will satisfy it. So we have dy1 by dx plus px into y1 equal to qx, and dy2 by dx plus px into y2 is also equal to qx. Right, now let us say this is 1, 2 and this is 3. So from 1 minus 2 we will get d by dx of y minus y1 plus px into y minus y1 is equal to 0. Similarly, 2 minus 3 we will get d by dx of y1 minus y2 plus px into y1 minus y2 is equal to 0. Right, we have got these two equations. Now px can also be removed from these two equations. Let us see, this can be written equal to d by dx of y minus y1 is equal to minus px into y minus y1. Also we have d by dx into y1 minus y2 is equal to minus px into y1 minus y2. So if we will divide these two, we have d by dx into y minus y1 divided by y minus y1 is equal to d by dx of y1 minus y2 divided by y1 minus y2. Right, so this is the equation we have obtained. Now if we integrate it, so we will get ln y minus y1 is equal to ln y1 minus y2 plus constant. Let us say we write ln c. So its solution is y minus y1 equal to y1 minus y2 into c. That is, our solution is y equal to y1 plus y1 minus y2 into c. So from the given options we can see option number b is the only correct answer. Now question number 55, it says if the linear combination alpha y1 plus beta y2 also be a solution of given differential equation, then we have to find alpha plus beta. See, if this is a solution of the given differential equation, it will satisfy it, which means d by dx of alpha y1 plus beta y2 plus px into alpha y1 plus beta y2 is equal to qx. Right, so we can write it as, taking alpha common, d by dx of y1 plus y1 px plus, taking beta common, d by dx of y2 plus px y2, this is equal to qx. Now as we already knew y1 and y2 are already satisfying it, so we have alpha into, from equation 2 and 3 this can be written as qx plus beta qx is equal to qx. Right, so qx is cancelled, which means alpha plus beta is equal to 1. So answer is option number b.